I have yet to introduce the author of this drama, Afra Behn. A remarkable character, she led an eventful life full of the outrageous and the improbable, a little like this story. Afra Behn was born in Wye, near Canterbury, in 1640. Her mother was nurse to the Culpeppers, a rich family in the neighbourhood. A son of the Culpeppers, who later described Afra as his foster sister, may have been responsible for her later entry to court life. At the age of 23, she seems to have visited an English sugar colony in Suriname, where she is said to have met and maybe had an affair with an African slave leader. Years later, this episode became the inspiration for one of her most successful plays. Back in England, she married, but her husband seems to have died soon afterwards, perhaps in the outbreak of the plague that killed 100,000 people in London between 1665 and 1666. In 1666, through connections at the English court, and herself a confirmed royalist, she was recruited as a spy for King Charles II. England was at war with the Spanish Netherlands, and using the codename Astrea, Afra Behn went to Antwerp to liaise with English supporters in Holland. The king turned out to be a bad employer, however, and unpaid and heavily in debt, she was sent to prison. Here she decided to start writing, stories which have many striking similarities to her own checkered history. She became one of the first and most successful female writers in England. When she died in 1689, she was buried in Westminster Abbey, then a unique honour for a woman writer. Abdelaziz was written in 1676. Purcell composed his incidental music to it in 1695, the year of his death.